Good afternoon, friends. Today I am going to take this session on the administrative relations between the center and the state. So we are doing the center-state relations. In the center-state relations topic, we have divided into three topics. That is the legislative relations, the administrative relations, and the financial relations. So in this aspect, we have done with the legislative relations. So in this class, I am going to take on the administrative relations, guys. So after this, I will take this separate session on financial relations. So the topic for today's discussion is administrative relations. So the administrative relations we are going to deal with. Guys, this is part of the center-state relations. So I need to write the center state relations before this, guys. Okay, center state relations. Okay, so in the center state relations, this is the administrative relations which takes after this as subtopic. So the articles deals in the administrative relations. We are having the, that is from 256 to 263. So these are the articles that deal with the center administrative relations in center state relations, guys. Okay, so in the center state relations topic, we have the legislative, administrative, and the financial relations. Okay, we have done with the legislative. Okay, and in this we are taking the administrative relations. What are the administrative relations that we are having with the center and the state? Okay, so I start my discussion with article number 26, article number 256. So if I take article number 256, it says that, guys, it says that article number 250 says that it is the obligation of the state, it is the obligation of the state to follow the parliamentary law. Okay, to follow the parliamentary law. So what does it mean? Means it is the obligation. It is not as a means it is not as our wish. Okay, it is obligation means we must follow. It is the obligation of the state to follow the parliamentary law. So guys, in the article 245 in the SLS class, we have seen article 245 in the SLS class, we have seen parliament can make the law to the part of India or the whole of India. Okay, so in that the parliament will make the laws to the part of India or whole of India, but the parliament is the power of making the laws. Then who are the one to go into implement? So parliament will make the law at the center, means at the parliament, but these laws should be implemented throughout India. But we should know how and when. So which is the organization that going to implement this or this law. So that's why we are having the administrative relations. Okay, in the previous class, that is in the legislative relations, they are going to deal with the with respect to the law making powers, whether it be parliament or the state level. Now in the administrative relations, who are going to administer in this, the parliament, this the articles made by the parliament or the state legislature. That's why, so we are not having the executive powers, we are not having the division of the executive powers. Our form of government we are having the, that is the unique features of our government. If you people remember in the federal structure, I explained. Okay guys, ours in a parliamentary form of government, and that is executive is responsible to the legislature. Executive is responsible to the legislature. That's why we are not having the division of powers of the executive. We are not having the division of powers of the executive. So we have the Central Council of Ministers, we have the State Council of Ministers, but the executive means these are the temporary executives. We have permanent executives like bureaucrats. Okay, they are going to implement the laws made by the parliament. So parliament will make the law at the center, but this should be implemented at the state level also. This should be implemented at the state level also. So for that, as it is the executive is in the co-junction, or you can say in the coordination with the legislature, guys. That's why we are not having the division of powers of the executive. Okay, so it is the obligation of the state to follow the parliamentary law. So whatever the law made by the parliament at the center, so if the parliament will make any law, that law will be implemented by the state legislature in their respective states. In their respective states. I will take this with an example. So recently we have the Motor Vehicle Amendment Act. Motor Vehicle Amendment Act. So in that what happened, you know, the parliament have made hefty fines for violation of the rules. Hefty fines for the violation of the rules. But the state government said that we are not going to consider that rule. We are not going to consider that law and we want to have separate law. Like that few states have made the separate law also. Like the West Bengal and the Rajasthan. Okay guys. So what means, if you are against the center law, if you are against the parliamentary law, then you are going against Article 256. You are going against Article 256. So our constitution itself mentioned it is the obligation of the states to follow the parliamentary law. Means this law made by the parliament should be implemented by the state. So we have state executives. So state executives in their respective state will implement the laws made by the parliament. Okay guys. That is, as I explained in the example, so if anyone is violating that, then it is against the Article 256. This is about Article 256, very very important. Very very important. For example, we have the MNREGA, the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Act. Okay guys, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act 2005 or 2006 we are having. Okay, it is 2005 but it is implemented in 2006. But this will be having a stay at the central, means the law made at the parliamentary. But if you see, this law is implementing at the local level government, guys. Okay, at the local level means providing much employment to the people who are in need. Okay guys, so the state executive is implementing the laws. Okay, this is about this topic guys. Okay, about Article 256. So guys, this is about Article 256. So now I will take the Article number 257 guys. Okay, Article number 257. So if you take Article number 257, it says that it's central's control over the certain provisions in the state guys. Okay, it says that central's central control over certain provisions in states. Okay, so central control over certain provisions in the states. So what exactly this article depicts? So if you see, central control over certain provisions in the states. So in the states which are of the national interest, which are of the national interest. Okay, which are of the national interest. Guys, if you see, we are having the, like the military, we call it as armored forces. We are having the armored forces, that is the military, navy and the air force. Okay, armored forces. So armored forces will comes under the, that is the center guys. So the provisions regarding the armed forces enter will be dealt with the center. But we have few stations, we have few bases of the armed forces at different locations of the country guys. So as if we say that our center, so our capital, that is our main block is, that is New Delhi. So not only in the New Delhi, we are having the few bases of the armed forces in different places like Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai and all those things. That's why that is the center control, that is the, it is the center's control over certain provisions. So these are the provisions in the states. So wherever the states we are having that, like the armed forces, after that we are having the national waterways, okay, national highways and also railways, and also railways, very very important topic. So railways, as you people about this, it is the center guys. So the railways are all India will be dealt with the central. So we are not having the separate state railways. Okay, but their establishment have made in the states. That's why the state can give control. The state, sorry, the center can give direction to the state. Okay, regarding these provisions. Regarding these provisions, the center can give directions to the states. That's why there is an interference of the center in the some provisions, that is in the center, certain cases which are of the national interest. Like I said, the armed forces, national waterways, national highways and the railways. Okay guys, so you people can't say that it is present in the state, so it is the control of the state. No, it is of the national interest. So railways is of national interest, that's why the center will have interface in these matters if they are present in the state also. That is, it deals with article 257. It deals with article 257. Okay, and after this we have article 258. Yes, okay, 258. Guys, 257, it is obligation of the state to follow the parliamentary law. So 257, the center's control over certain provisions in the state. Now I will take article 258. 258 says that, okay, article 258, article 250 says that it is the power of the union, okay, to confer on the states. Power of union, okay, power of the union to confer on, to confer etc. on states. Okay, so it is the power of the union to confer on states. Okay, so what is article depicts? Guys, we are having the article 256 and 257. So the 256 and 257 are related to the center. Why? Because 256 is the, that is the parliamentary. So whereas 257 is the center's control. So how they are going to give directions to the states? How they are going to give directions to the states? So in the article 256 and in the 257, it is the from center to state. So this, there is a center in the 256 article, that is the parliament. So it is the obligation of the state to follow the parliamentary law. And the same in the, so that is same in the 257, it is the center's control on the state and the matters of the national interest, and it will be done by the states. So who is the one going to implement this 256 and 257? That's why we are having article 258. It is the power of the union to confer etc. on states. Okay, to confer etc. on the states. Okay guys, so this will be made through the governor, guys. Okay, so through the governor. So governor plays a very very important role in implementing the articles 256 and 257. Okay, in implement the articles 256 and 257. So the information, so we have the governor as a person, guys, as a person between the center and the state. So whatever the laws, so whatever the provisions in this, that is in the 256 and 257, to be implemented, to be made, or any direction, it will come to the governor. It will come to the governor. So the governor will inform to the executive. Governor is an executive, guys. It will inform to the state executive, and state, they are going to implement it. They are going to implement. So governor is discussed with the council of ministers, and they are going to make as division, and they are going to implement this provisions, guys. Wonderful, wonderful we are having, guys. Wonderful provisions we are having. So everything we people are know, but how it is going to implement in this manner. Okay, so this is the importance of article 258, and article 258 we are having, guys. So we have one more article, that is 258 class A. Okay, sorry, 258 here, not class A, guys. It is 258, sorry, we have separate article 258. It deals with the power of the state. Okay, power of state to entrust functions to the union. Okay, it says that it is the power of the state to entrust, guys, to do something, guys. Okay, to do something for someone. to do something for someone, that is the functions to the union. So what are the union provisions that we are having in the articles 256 and 257 that are going to implement in this? And it says to 258A, it has been its provision days. Okay, it has been its provision in the article 258A. So this is about 256, 257 and 258, guys. I think I am clear, guys. Okay, so let us move to the next article, guys. Okay, so we are not having 259, guys. Okay, 259 have been repealed, so directly we go for 260. Okay, directly we go for 260, guys. Okay, article 260. What is article 260 repeals? It is the union, guys. Union to have jurisdiction outside the territory of India. Union to have jurisdiction outside the territory of India. Okay, guys, very very important article. This says that union to have jurisdiction outside the territory of India. Okay, we have some territorial India, guys. Like for example, roughly I am taking, guys. Okay, so it is India. Like for example, roughly I sketch. So union to have jurisdiction outside the territory of India, guys. Okay, it's very very important provision. Why? Because so what happens, you know, guys? In India, they will go for some fraud or some illegal things and all those things. Simply, they will escape outside the territory of India. They go to some other country, that is like Pakistan and all those things. Like we are having examples of the Vijay Mallya and the Nirav Modi. Vijay Mallya and the Nirav Modi. So, then article 260 says this, wherever you go, I am present over here. It says that. So, it is having the power of the union to have jurisdiction outside the territory of India. That's why, so for the people like the Nirav Modi and the Vijay Mallya, we have the act like Fugitive Economic Offender Act, guys. Very 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 important. Fugitive Economic Offender Act. Okay, Offender Act. So I think it's in 2019 we have something, guys. I have no idea. So Fugitive Economic Offender Act. So what does this economic offender? So if anyone who is in making the fraud of 100 crores and above flew to the other countries, then we consider it him as a fugitive economic offender. Means he will be have some provisions, so he will have penalties and all those things, guys. Okay, fugitive economic offender. After this, we have made after the Nirav Modi's case. Okay, guys, this is about article 260, union to have its jurisdiction outside the territory of India, guys. Okay, very very important article. So everything we are studying. So everything things we are known, we are having the provisions regarding those in the constitution, guys. Just we need to know things what we are having, guys. That's it. Okay. So I will take article number 261. What article 261 depicts? Okay. Very very important, guys. Article 261 also. Okay. Article 261. It says that faith and credibility. Okay. Faith and credibility to the provisions of the accords. Okay, guys, like a public acts, records, okay, and judiciary throughout the territory of India, okay. Throughout the territory of India, that is the faith and credibility to public acts, records or judiciary throughout the territory of India, guys. So it is very important. What do you mean by faith? Faith, guys, we have faith in everything. We have faith in this, that is in the public acts, records or judiciary. Credibility means truthness. Credibility says the truthness. Okay, we have the faith and truthness to the public acts. So what are the public acts we are having on the records on the judiciary? So whatever the judiciary, like if you are not able to get the judiciary at the lower level, you can move to the higher level of judiciary. But the records whatever present in the judiciary at the lower level, the judgments you can take to the higher courts. You have the right to take to the higher courts. That's why whenever we speak, don't say it is independent judiciary. We have independent and integrated judiciary. Independent and integrated judiciary. So we should have the truth and credibility about the public acts, records and the judiciary throughout the country of India. So what are the records that we have maintained? It can be available, it can be published, or it has its provision, it has its jurisdiction throughout the territory of India. And the public acts. Okay, a public acts means the parliament will make the laws on the, that is to the whole of India, guys. Okay, this is about the article 261, guys. Okay, very very important article. Now I will take article 262. Okay, very very important, guys. All these administrative articles are very important. Okay, so they will ask us the provisions and is there any provisions regarding this in the constitution or not. So then you should know which are the provisions that we are having in the constitution or not. So if I take article 262, it is about the interstate water tribunal. Okay, interstate water tribunal. Okay, interstate water tribunal. So if you see, it is the adjudication of the parliament to have the adjudication of the parliament to have the provision regarding the river waters or valleys. Okay, so this is mentioned in the constitution 262 article. So very very important, guys. So in the article 262, it is the interstate water tribunal. So interstate water tribunals will be formed by this parliament only. So adjudication of the parliament to have the provision regarding the river waters or the valley disputes. Okay, so river water or the valley disputes with respect to the quantity of water or the flow of water, okay, and all those things. So I will take this with an example, guys. We have Kaveri water dispute. So Kaveri water dispute mainly between Tamil Nadu and the Karnataka. Okay, Tamil Nadu and the Karnataka. So if it is a dispute with the one state, then they will resolve. So it is a two state dispute, then who is going to take, that is with respect to the parliament, and this is with respect to water. So the water then they can form the water tribunal, guys. So the water tribunal will form, and the water tribunal will take the measures to whom we need to have the equity sharing of the water. Equality is different from equity. Equity means depends upon the requirement we share the water. It is called equity, like 60-40. Okay, it is equity, guys. Whereas it is 50-50, it is called equality. So these things we are dealing with in the article 262 regarding the interstate water tribunals and all those provisions, guys. Okay, regarding the sharing, regarding the run of the water, okay, all those things will be dealt with in the article 262, interstate river water dispute. Okay, important topic, guys. Okay, they will ask any questions. Is there any provision regarding the water dispute in the constitution? Yes, we are having the article 262, that is to form the interstate water tribunals. The parliament have given the power to form interstate water tribunals if there is a water issue between the two or more states. This we are having in article 262. Okay, so today's article, last article for today's discussion is article 263. So what article 263 deals with? Article 263 deals with and the important provision, that is interstate councils and interstate council, guys. Okay, interstate council. This I am going to take again as a separate topic, guys. So after the center state relations, I will go for the emergency provisions. I will take this interstate council. So in article 263 says it has given the power to the president. Okay, it has given the power to the president to form the interstate council. So what is the need to have interstate council? So interstate council will be formed when there is an issue with the two or more states. Okay, two or more states have any conflict, then the president can form the interstate council. So with respect to any issues, any matters to resolve them, the presidents can form the interstate case. We have states, okay? Interstate disputes, okay? That is two or more states. And second one, if there is an issue with the state or the states with union, okay? So state or states with union, guys. Like that, if there is any issue with this, so with respect to any matters, they can form, guys. Okay, and third one, so on any subject, then the president can form interstate council and they give recommend to the states. On any subject matter if required, then the parliament have given, sorry, the constitution have given the power to form the president, the interstate council for this any three provisions. Okay, this is about article 263, guys. So with this, I am closing this session, guys. That is the administrative relations. So we have done with two topics in the center state relations. That is the previous we have done with the legislative, now administrative relations. So the last topic that we are left in the center state relationship is financial relations, guys. So, okay, after the financial relations, I will take the emergency provisions, and after that I will take the interstate council, guys. Okay, with this we complete the governance part. Okay, some means how our country exists as a governance. Okay, guys, thank you one and all.